What's up, you guys? Welcome back to another episode of Hustle with Sava. You and I, we hustle together. It is officially the second last day of my internship. Can you believe it? 5 years ki degree. Bas ab do din mein khatam ho jayegi. Majorly, y'all have been there for the longest part of my journey because I started YouTube when I was in my second year. And ever since, I've been a YouTuber and a therapist both, and a student firstly, and now a therapist. And it's just crazy. I'm going to be graduating in 2 days, honey, 2 days. Even though we went in the pandemic till the hospital, met each other, did all the shebang and everything, even then we are not having convocation in person. But the last day we've decided, we've bought caps on Amazon and we are going to do the signing and everything. Like, we'll have our own mini celebration. So I've carried some amount of makeup with me in my bag. I'm not doing anything now because mask pehnungi to sab chup jayega. I have prettier earrings also, so we'll like change up just before we take photos and stuff. And also, by the way, my car is in the garage. So Uber aa chuki hai, so let's go down. Today is officially my second last day. How do you feel? 5 years I went here to KEM. Come rain, come shine, come flood, tsunami, cyclone, everything. I went. You didn't care only about me.
You did a great job.
Where is my car come? Uber ka itna kharcha mein ko uthana pad raha hai. Main na jab bhi meri gaadi garage mein jati full tank jati hai. Full tank wapas nahi aati hai.
इंजन ही वापस नहीं आता है, फुल टैंक तो छोड़ दे।
तुम चुप रहो, तुम ज्यादा बोलो मत। चलो बाय मम्मी, बाय 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 भैया। देजुल, विल यू मिस अस?
वेरी मच।
या ओनली बिकॉज़ ही हैज़ टू डू ऑल द वर्क। ऐसा नहीं
है। नहीं
मोनिका।
फुल अटेंडेंस शीट साइन। कितने एब्सेंट हुए? 5। एक बच्चा है तेरा?
Six
exact absentees. Proud of you. Disha, do you want to show us yours?
It's okay.
Bichari, she was keeping her league and then COVID ho gaya.
Roshni doing the dance while going to give her attendance. She's so happy. It's over.
Chal lunch ke liye jaate. Of course, wow. It's hot. Look at the mug ka halat that Chotu's made. I specifically told him katha mat ghumana us pe.
Yesterday Dimple was like, when we were discussing na ki ek cap kab hai, so we were like first come first serve. Aise wo laga denge, paise do cap lo, paise do cap lo.
Guys, it's black, golden and white.
The ribbon she was saying she'll do in red one. Shall I
So we are having a send off because we went and spoke to our HOD and she allowed us. It's a small thing, only with cake. So just now Roshni ordered our cake and I have to put the message on the group so that everybody in our batch knows that कल हमारा सेंड ऑफ है, लास्ट डे है, ये ब्लैक व्हाइट रेड स्क्रोल पे
टॉक टू हर वंस, टेल हर दैट बिफोर आई पे, टेल हर जी पे कर रहे हैं
फोटोज, यू आर वेयरिंग मास्क बिकॉज़ गोइंग टू टेक सम फोटोज, सो विदाउट मास्क के थोड़े तो फोटोज आने ही चाहिए. थोड़ा आगे तो अब बारिश हो रही है फटाफट, फिर वार्ड भी जाना है. बैग्स अभी थोड़े तो गीले होंगे या गाड़ी पे रख सकते हो, किसी की भी गाड़ी के ऊपर. We took a lot of good photos even though it was raining. That is the kind of dedication we have towards taking photos. Roshni is not convinced. She never is convinced. Disha was up.
Yeah,
our photographer is excellent, guys. I will leave her contact details. You should contact her.
Early the next morning.
I don't know, but can you hear that? Can you hear the thunderstorm? It's been thundering and raining since 6 a.m. I was telling these people yesterday only ke what if this din humko caps uchhalna hai and photo lene hai, usi din barish hogi because hamari kismat hi aisi chal rahi hai abhi. But yeah, good morning you guys. All the lights in my room are on in the morning because it's raining horribly in Bombay. And the worst part is that where our college is, that's like a low-lying area. So udhar thoda bhi barsaat hota hai na, it just floods. It just gonna be walking in gutter water, dude. It's bad. Like the amount of times that we've been stuck, every rains we do get stuck over there. Everything was just hitting me last night and how today is officially the last day. Just we are trying to have a small send-off celebration because I don't know if we can have a graduation, a convocation, or a celebration because with the pandemic, everything is unpredictable, dude. We don't know what's gonna happen tomorrow. So it's just we've spent a lot of time at this institute. It feels like we came as kids who did not know what we were doing. Maybe we still don't know what we are doing as adults. But and yesterday, you know, I had this room on Clubhouse. Let me just have my coffee. I've just woken up. I had my breakfast and I got ready. I'm doing my skincare also simultaneously while having bath. I washed my face. This is the cleanser that I use all the time. This is my Dermaweave Hydra cleanser. It's basically a soap-free cleanser, which is why I love it. Because anything soap nowadays in my like cleansers irritates my face. Most importantly, irritates my eyes. Yeah, I mean, maybe we still don't know what we want to do in life. Maybe we still are clueless. Because I think that that phase of your life where you have hesitation with your career never really dies, and that was our Clubhouse topic yesterday night, where we were discussing if leaving academics to be an influencer, because a lot of the youth today keep messaging me and a lot of other creators also, I guess, that, you know, should I leave my studies to just become an influencer, just become an influencer. And I'm like, dude, there's so much to just becoming an influencer. You have to learn everything. You have to be your own filmmaker. You have to be your own manager. You have to be your own CA. Everything in the beginning. Like, you just have to figure it all out. And there's no school for all this. So, like, the whole conclusion of the entire conversation was, no matter what you do in life, be it being a model, be it being a doctor, be it being anything, an influencer, content creator, whatever you want to call it, just have a backup plan, you know, and education provides you that. Academics gives you a backup plan wherein you just have a degree that kal ko tum jaake bol sakte ho, that even with less salary, I have this degree, can you give me some job, right? So academics just secures you like that. Like, it's always good to have that. Like, when I was in second year, I started my YouTube channel. I wasn't sure about both, okay? I wasn't sure about occupational therapy also, because agar mujhe abroad jaane nahi milta, to occupational therapy scope in India is not as good as abroad. Like, abroad, an occupational therapist will be getting paid like, dude. And in India, we barely get paid, you know, at the clinics and hospitals. And the same applied for being a YouTuber, because I did not know anyone who was a YouTuber, did not have anybody in the industry, no friends whatsoever. Like, today I know so many people, have made friends along the way, but starting mein aisa nahi tha. So just keeping both my options open, my plan B just turned into my plan A. Like, today at least I'm not banking all my eggs on my occupational therapy degree and being like, I have to go abroad, I have to get a job, I have to do this. In the pandemic, we all know the job market has become bad, going abroad for your studies is bad, and it's just up and down, right? You know, it's not secure. So that is the time when I'm tapping into being a YouTuber, and I'm keeping it on hold, but that doesn't mean I'm completely ditching it. So it's always good to have all your baskets filled with eggs, and you know, it just requires you to work harder, because I have worked 16, 18 hours a day. I've sometimes not even slept because I was working, but that just gives me the peace of mind today, knowing that okay, I don't have to take the tension ke mere paas kaam nahi hoga, you know. So just that kind of security is what I've worked for. I feel like it just rewarded me in the right place at the right time. And yeah, sometimes you work very hard and don't get rewards also. So alhamdulillah, I'm very grateful that actually my hard work has paid off, and it's not just gone in the drain where I don't know what I'm doing with both my careers, because that could have also been an option. Just life is so unpredictable. Like, it sucks that sometimes it's like a movie where you don't know what the end is. By the way, I'm not wearing just this, because if I was wearing a racer back, I would have worn a what is that called? Strapless bra? Yeah, strapless bra. But I'm wearing a cardigan because I don't wear sleeveless to college very readily. And today I don't know if we'll be wearing the apron and taking photos, or we'll take without it. So I'll just go ahead and moisturize. I'm using my Dermaweave moisturizing lotion, and I'll moisturize my body before I put on my cardigan. It's a great moisturizer. It's lightweight. You know what? Comment down below and tell me if you've already graduated from college, what is the best memory you have from college? I really want to know. I really want to know. Let me tell you, my best memory has to be all the college fests, because college fest life is a whole mood. Like, especially because we work at the hospital, we studied at a hospital, so it's like a BMC hospital where full-blown patients coming in, patients going out, and fully life functioning in a different way. And on the other side, we are roaming with like kapde ka material and being like, ye silana hai, wo silana hai, because fest life, you know, you need costumes and you need this. It's so hilarious and it's so much fun. I've had the best time, especially because I didn't have 11th, 12th college life. I went to these integrated colleges which don't give you any college life. You just have to study, 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 and you get marked for attendance. This also happens in Bombay. I don't know if it happens in other cities, but it happens in Bombay, especially when you're giving like medical entrance, engineering entrance. You have these integrated colleges that allow you to not attend college, attend classes, and you get marked for attendance. So that's one of the colleges that I went to. So I didn't have 11th, 12th college life, a regular college life. And that's why KEM was my everything. It was my whole and soul. That institution, GSMC, has just changed my life. Like, I strongly believe that you should always get a good institute, because you meet amazing people, you meet great professors, you learn so much of life from the best, you know. So even if you've not taken, like, even if I didn't get MBBS in KEM, I still took a course that is in KEM, and just getting that name attached to me, it's everything. The memories of KEM, I will never forget. Those life lessons, I will never forget. Right, I'll put on my cardigan. This cardigan is by H&M and my top is by Vera Moda, in case you're wondering. I really like this cardigan and it used to be one of my favorite until I dropped foundation over here, which I don't think you can see. It's like two small drops. But literally all of my nice clothes I've dropped foundation on at this point, and I'm just so angry at myself. Next up, face moisturizer. I'm using my Nutriderm Vitamin E as always. I put a serum, so I was just letting my serum do its magic before I go in for my face moisturizer, so that's what I like to do. And I'm not taking too much product because it's not needed. It's a nice and humid weather, so a lot of the moisture is getting soaked into my skin.
All the best for your future. 5 years of your university.
Good. You're happy, na? That I became a doctor.
Yeah.
Bas hua. Bas tum khush raho, mere ko aur kuch nahi.
Now, when you do your further education.
Further education ka pata nahi. Mummy, abhi main ja rahi hu ye education khatam karne. Baaki ka baad mein dekhenge abhi. Chhata to tumhari chakkar mein main chhata bhul jaungi. Ek to meri height ka koi hai bhi. Main fujab.
You should hold the umbrella.
I hold, then the other person gets wet,
na? So that's okay.
It's the umbrella. What do you feel? Bye, mom.
Bye, Raja.
Love. These are our batchmates who have to come to this building. Look at the amount of water that gets spilled over here every year. Pull it. Whites ke upar white hi pehna hai maine.
Tere jaisa smart koi nahi hota. Film mein aise workshop mein din bhar aise baithi rehti
thi. Pehla patient dekhi nahi pehna. Kya
hi farak padta.
Just shut up. It's a big reveal of the cake. Yay! You successfully bought it from so far. Can you take this chair this side? Pinterest dreams coming true right here. Where are our graduation caps? Samosa ki kya strong smell aa rahi hai na?
This is fun.
Come, jao man.
Many hours later.
Become super fast, very techie parents. Very pro, y'all have become. Look at them. I just sent them this photo. Abhi WhatsApp pe
bheji. They're learning from you, no?
Oh. Disha has come to the house, so Fudge is greeting her. Fudge doesn't give any fudge for me. So cute. Thanks.
Alright guys, I got home and my parents have become so super fast with all this media thing, hai na? Maine kal unko WhatsApp pe photo bheja tha to tell them ki this is what is happening, which is why I'm late. So that was very cool to come home to, and my father got a bouquet and everything. I'm just happy that everything turned out well eventually. Like, the cake was tasty, it looked good, and everyone was happy. We took a lot of nice photos. Just like a small celebration, but that's the best we can have in the pandemic. Like, it's been all up and down, and we didn't even know if we would have this much of a celebration. The jo bhi mila chota sa achha hi tha. But officially, I'm a graduate, okay? We are done here. We wind up. I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. If you did, then don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. For today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to
Roshni. Shout out to Roshni. I'm getting a shout out.
There is a Roshni Rathod in the.
This is OG Roshni Rathod. I'm so sorry.
Did you see my last video with some comment?
I have her phone, just hold on.
Disha and Fudge are having.
But I never get a shout out.
You don't do the rules of hashtag Sara Squad.
Oh, yeah.
Sare rules follow karne hote. Fudge is living his best life. With Disha pampering him and so many people around, doesn't give a fudge about me. Fudge, I'll get a new doggy now that you don't care anymore. Get a new doggy.
Don't you dare.
For today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to Divena Patel. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video Sara Squad shout out, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button, the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad, and you get a chance to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shout out. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, love you.